Hello everybody, it's the Baron here, and we are doing another Let's Play of Paragon. This will be a highlight reel, essentially, of the game that I played recently that went fairly well. So as you can see, I'm mid-laning in this particular game, trying to deal with this Countess that they've got on the other team, who is their mid-laner. Now, essentially, we're going to talk a little bit about strategy and what I tried to do during the game. And a big thing is staying close and trying to keep the pressure up while minimizing the amount of damage you take, obviously. Now, this is a fairly decent matchup for me. Greystone's got a lot of armor, he's a powerful character. Countess is good if you know how to use him, so you have to be extremely careful with her around. So I do that thing where I try to pressure them quite a bit. The thing is, you want to try and keep them away from your units dying so they don't get the XP. So it's no harm in trying to pressure them a little bit to try and keep them away. Especially since I can damage mine really fast, and I've already punished her every time she tries to get too close. So I'm basically trying to eliminate the minions as fast as I can so we can start putting pressure on her. So when I really focus on trying to get his damage up as high. So I'm very lucky at this point. If I would have got caught by these guys chasing me, it would have been all over for me, but I do get away. Wish I could say that was having something to do with the talent of mine, but that was a lot of luck that the guy just happened to miss. But it ended up working out really well. I still have a relatively large amount of health. Now at this point, I didn't notice that right away because I have a bad habit of looking at minions. But he gets into a full engagement. I don't have an ability to come back, so I bail. I didn't think I could help him, so I avoided the whole conflict. Not my bravest decision, but an unfortunate one you got to make in this game sometimes. You don't want to feed them two deaths, which is likely what would have happened. I like Greystone because he's fairly easy to take care of the tower. Normally what you want to do if you're fighting underneath the tower, you want to try and get the finishing hits as much as you can. But I try and attack the ranged distance units that are there because one of them gets bonus damage to towers. So you want to get them down as quickly as you can. As you can see, as soon as I engaged with Countess, I disengaged. I took off. But I don't want to abandon the tower, so I stick around. She had full MP. I'm only one level ahead of her, so I'm not getting a tremendous scaling amount. And at this point, I see that Crunch is here, so I can take off and spend my 3 card points. So this one, we get into a triple engagement, 2v2. My ally doesn't do so hot. Oh, I'm trying to get my... There we go. I don't quite manage to get both of them. But I get one, we'll take that. In that instance, I didn't get my stuff back quick enough, and she managed to totally evade me at the end there, which is unfortunate, but part of the game sometimes. We got 1-on-1, or 1v1, we took a death, they took a death. We can accept that trade-off. I could have kept pushing the tower, but this isn't my main lane. I basically came this way as I noticed that some of them needed to go back to heal, and I think one of them might have died, so I decided to take over for them and help them out. And now we obviously need help in the right lane, so we're heading that way. Get the tower out. Through to some wards. Avoid his attack. Now, I haven't been around this Greystone, so I'm not sure if he's actually close to death or not. Like, if he's already been killed once or not. All I know is I can't afford my own, so. A bit more avoiding. Focus on protecting the tower until an ally can come and relieve me.
I actually got 2 on the offlane.
Just barely get out of there. Oh, I do take the hit from a Countess from behind. I don't want to abandon the station because I know that that Greystone took a hit as well. And with her gone, she totally abandoned him, and my Countess here to help. We clean him up. last hit so that we know the minions are going to go, realize what's happening so I come back to try and help. Was not able to save her. Maybe we can punish this count just a bit. Oh yes, and I misclicked. I didn't send my jump attack far enough out. At this point we are charging at the tower to try and protect ourselves, trying to save it. So I've been working in this lane, you notice the CP jump and an XP jump since the last one. And somebody decides to ask for surrender, even though I'm doing super good, and I believe our team is on par. We're not winning, but it's close enough to doing okay. I've lost one inhibitor and been able to come back from the game, so I had no interest in that. I decided to be brave and try and take on a couple of them, and I realized as I was retreating that all of my allies came to help. They realized what I was doing and came to finish them off. So I was able to nail the kill for one of the guys. Teammates got the second one. We're in great shape. And we retreat from a great engagement. So at this point they're pushing on what I always feel is one of the most important towers, the one that's going to take away our ability to jump. We've already lost one in this case, but I always try and protect these towers. Run after these guys. There's 2v1. Again, I have a bad habit of staring directly at the minions instead of looking at the fight that's happening above, like right there. And in hindsight, looking at this, it's so obvious. You can see them fighting just gently up in the top right corner. This Grux was strong enough. He got one of them all by himself. He gets hung up back there on this guy's attack. But with that, I'm able to come in there and help him finish off without losing either of us, which is, thank goodness. He would have been awfully mad had I screwed that up any worse than I already did by not quite doing what I'm supposed to do. So here I'm trying to warn everyone that the middle lane's about to go down if I don't get some help. Push over there. Now in this case, there's two heroes, and I know that one of them, Countess in particular, is pretty squishy. So I'm like, maybe I should be able to kill her. It works out. I was going to attack that far distance one because of how much damage they do, but at level 10, these heroes are actually doing fairly decent damage and are decently powerful. He decides to engage, doesn't have much options at that point, and we finish it, saving the tower. Now we're jumping in to gank the other Greystone. He pushed far on the right, Countess asked for help, so I'm running over to try and help her out. The big danger with Greystone, because he slows people down, it was tricky with the timing because the Countess couldn't get caught in that, or she might have died. So we didn't want to risk that. So you push up into that point, and then you call it a day, depending on who you're fighting with and if you can contact them. Like if you're Skyping or not. We weren't Skyping. I believe I was soloing this. I don't know anyone who's in this game with me. Thankfully that crunch comes to help me out. I'm trying to decide whether I can stay and engage, because I can afford one death without too much at risk. I run a little too far before I realize that actually that crunch is excellent and I might be able to help him out. This one I want to be careful not to miss time the jump. We ended up solidifying the two kills that crunch got, which, again, he's having a pretty excellent game too as he scales. So we decided to push the towers together. Obviously, we're at a little bit of a tower disadvantage at the moment, so we're trying to push up a bit. Need a big push. He's a little low on health. I'm healing. I have a attack steal card on right now. So now with the Greystone, again, he's not great. I'm 3 levels ahead of him. Countess asked for help and decide to bail. And on my way to help the other lane, run into this guy. Hasn't quite learned yet that he can't 1v1 me. That 2 level advantage plus my high damage attack cards makes it a little tough for him. So again, we're going to end up protecting this tower. We got these two guys. I have a level advantage on them, so things should go fairly well. Countess does a really well-timed one that allows us to finish off Sivirog. So again, we try and position ourselves, make it harder for him to run away. Now this is a little ugly. We managed to finish him off. And I try to climb up a mountain. I've noticed lately I've been trying to play it safer, as safe as possible, so we decided to bail on that one. Now we're pushing up the right-hand side. I'm right on top of their tower. This is just on the back of us killing three of them, I believe. And then the Chimera went down, but all of his teammates are back now. Doing a full tower push. Everyone was on the far left, giving me plenty of time to attack this tower. Again, I attacked the minions first. I should have finished them off, but I'm doing a tremendous amount of damage at this point, so I figure I can just jump. And then I decide to go for it on the inhibitor. Figure I've got high damage, everything's cool. I've got minions coming to back me up, so I can do another push. At that point, I probably should have bailed in hindsight, but I stuck around. Because I keep looking at the map, and no one's coming to stop me, so I'm continuing this push. Again, clear up the minions so that your minions can help you attack the tower. She needs help down there, the Countess. I know that, but I'm like, the tower's so close. If I can get this down, that's a huge advantage. There are two of them here. I decided to stick in this engagement. Terrible idea. They have such high damage. So I do a full bail. Full run. This darn Chimera is here. I do that as a deterrent to try and help me. He drops me. Not the end of the world. I'm getting closer. So I turn around to see if I can fight them, and that was a huge mistake. I should definitely have gotten the heck out of there. It was so close. And so here we open with another attempt at surrender, which I find absolutely hilarious, and I'm attacking a Countess who was trying to push up the middle lane. I get trapped on minions, which happens to me way more often than I'd like. She decides to engage. I decide to finish her. But because she engaged, I was a little wary there for a second, trying to decide, was anyone else there? Once I realized there wasn't, as you can see, I took the time to shut that down. Again, our left lane is getting pushed, so I decide to go for it. I don't have a tremendous amount of health, but I can die once. Again, I get hung up on minions. We are able to finish him off, which is fantastic, but we get the two kills, but again, two kills in exchange for one inhibitor, not the best trade-off. Finish clearing that up, and then I just head back to base. So we were at the enemy inhibitor at this point. We're pushing, they got the two guys. Again, the Chimera is here, I'm not super scared of him. I still have the three-level advantage. He decides to continue engaging, which works for me. But that's Wrath effectively stops me from attacking him, which so irritating. So we got the three, the one guy gets taken out by a snipe, which is awesome. Decent shape. Again, we really need to get another inhibitor down. I like attacking the same side that they took down so that the minions meet and you're not in the big disadvantage. I decide to go for the inhibitor. I do quite a bit of damage, so I'm hoping that'll do. Fortunately, that happens. I don't take any hits, though, thank goodness. We keep running. I run right into that. I take the hit. Up down, but I don't think that I have to run yet. Anyone left is fairly damaged. We're 1-3 kills at the moment in this particular engagement, so we still have options. Crunch is bringing up the right. We have about 20 seconds until that Chimera comes. Again, I'm not terribly scared of Sarath. But she is a high damage dealer, so she actually does hurt me quite a bit. We got the retreat from Countess there. Finish her off. I was debating staying, because I do have quite a lifesteal that might be able to carry me through. Which you'll see in a moment. I look up, Chimera's there, and I actually decided to stay so far anyway. I think this Chimera is extremely dangerous, so I can't decide what to do. Again, he gets more dangerous with every stroke. He gets more powerful. He does the jump. I'm not within the tower, thank goodness. And I can use, as you can see with my lifesteal, I'm using the minions around me to help me heal up. Able to finish him off, but I am extremely damaged right now. It's so close to death, the inhibitor is so close, I can't quite decide what I need to do right now. So I had to stay, try and heal up on them. I do have it back, so I can push for a little while here. Again, the enemy's on the back foot, so we do have some chances. And we take out another inhibitor. My thing is I like to get all the inhibitors down, that's my priority, so I run over to come to this guy. Get the jump right in there. And we get it down. I'm injured, so I'm using the minions to try and heal up so I can live longer against this Greystone. I do have one level advantage, but now there's three of them. This is pretty ugly. And because of the mass of minions behind them, I managed to get away. So a little bit of my deck build. Again, I'm increasing my lifesteal. Running back to engage. Our core's at 100. We still have two inhibitors up. Their core is down to 67%. And I do what I always do when I'm in decent shape. Attack Orb Prime. Now, why do I do that? That's a strategy. It's twofold. Even if you take some hits or take some deaths while you're trying to get it down, it ensures that the other team can't use them. Right? And that's the biggest way that they're going to come back into this game. So they get Orb Prime down and then take down an inhibitor or end the game. I'm also strong enough now that I should be able to do this by myself. Crunch is fairly damaged, but I think the two of us can do it, so I go for it. So again, the crunch we've got on this is very good. I don't know what his kill death is. I don't remember. But he definitely helped me get a lot of the 10 assists that I'm at right now. So I'm 13, 1, and 10. You can see around the map that we are having some issues. They're all doing a full push. They shouldn't be able to stop us from killing this. This is what we want. With that down, everyone's still alive. Now we can start dealing with this minion problem we got. Right lane is where I was headed, because when she said right lane, I'm like, okay. But I did not catch that the middle lane was being attacked right now. Again, our inhibitor is under attack. So they're all chasing right now. I decided to head back to try and save our core. Countess comes too. Countess is great at clearing minions, so it actually goes okay. So we're at 89 and 40%. It's getting there. We still have a pretty sizable advantage. We also have Orb Prime preventing them from using it. So they're pushing all the way, so I figure we can do the same. The minions are still spawning at approximately the same rate. And by that I mean they both have the best units. We lose our crunch, which is unfortunate, but we're still 2-2. I'm fairly confident that the two of us should be able to take the two of them. I'm just running to the middle. Taking river buff, another surrender vote, so I take the time to say that's a hard pass on that. Pushing all the way on the left-hand side, myself. Again, I haven't felt super threatened by anyone yet. I have the ability to die and come back, so I'm like, we're in great shape. I have full card power. I still have one unspent point, but I'm feeling like that won't make a huge difference. They're on the back foot cleaning up minions, so I'm trying to decide. I decide to push with the larger section of minions and try and take some heroes down. Again, with all of the enemy minions around me, I am in much better shape than normal. But then, without them around me now, I can't heal. So I decided to go for it. I still have the ability to die. They're all around me, but I figure let's give it a shot. I can't heal. She gets a snipe just as I come back. So our core is getting damaged just as I come back. We got a quick glimpse of my card power. As you can see, unspent points is still one. I messed up my card build slightly for this game. I managed to save it. It's 44 to 26. Still in decent shape. Decided to try and pick on this Greystone. Yeah, it's all about saving the minions and trying to save our core. Again, it's a tough battle. They're everywhere. They got the delay moves. They got the slowing. That helps me clear out the minions, but I'm still in tough shape here. I had to go back. I definitely need to heal up a little bit if we're going to have a shot of surviving this. Oh, I don't. That's right. That's too close. Oh, no, I do. I thought I did. So back. Try and heal up. I'm keeping my eye on it because I know they're going to do a endgame push here, and I don't want to lose to something like that. Turn that on. We're fighting, trying to kill them as quick as we can. Crunch really stepping up. Worked out super okay. We're 27-26. We're still in the dead heat. Again, at this point, you want to try and get in front of them so that they engage you, because they'll auto-engage the tower if you allow them to get too close. We're down 1-1 right now, which isn't the worst. Again, we're just trying to scare them off, keep ourselves alive. We really just want to clear as much as we can so that the minions will start pushing them again, instead of being on the back foot like we are now. Crunch gets a nice kill on Countess. It's being chased by Greystone, which I don't notice, as I need help, which finally makes me realize something's going on. He goes back to heal. Countess and I scare this guy off. So now we're fully alive. There's only two bad heroes around. He says attack middle. That's fine, but I know we need to stick around and save ourselves, right? Have someone playing defense, and I figured it might as well be me. I've been holding up fairly well against everyone. I'm keeping my eye on the Chimera on the other side. She says defend left lane is another hint that I should be moving back, so I do. At this point, I realize there's three of them, and our two guys are making a run for it, so it's going to be a tough sell, but we delay them as long as I can to try and give our team a chance. They do drop me. I make a run for it because I realize that while they were distracting me, she made a run for it. I get killed just as the game ends. Oh, and then we noticed that Sirrath has been missing this whole time. I had no idea we had a Sirrath on our team. I didn't even notice. We ended up losing with an absolutely majestic 16-11. Oh my god. Thanks for watching. This has been Baron.